What's going on, everybody? It's ETA Prime back here again with another Launchbox news video. Today, we're releasing Launchbox version 13.15. And just like all of our other releases, we've got some improvements, fixes, and some awesome new features. And I want to jump right into it with one of my favorite new features here, and this has to do with ScumVM. Now, in the past, it was a bit of a hassle getting ScumVM set up, but now with Launchbox 13.15, we've made it easier than ever. It used to be that Launchbox came bundled with ScumVM, but now we've got a ScumVM downloader, and I'm going to show you exactly how to use this. There's a couple ways of going about importing your ScumVM games into Launchbox, but I'm going to show you a method that I've been using, and in order for this to work properly, we will need automated imports enabled. From Tools, we're going to go to Options, right here at the top, Automated Imports. You need to make sure that this is on. That way, when we place ROMs in the correct location, Launchbox is automatically going to find them for us and download all of our metadata and artwork. On my desktop, I do have some ScumVM games. I'm going to place them in my Launchbox Games ScumVM directory. We'll just let these copy on over. Once everything's copied over, Launchbox is automatically going to start the import process for us. It's automatically going to scan that directory. We'll get a little notification up here. It's going to download all of our metadata and artwork for us. So I'm going to give this just a little bit of time to finish up. But you can see over here on the left-hand side, we've got our ScumVM section. As you can see, all of my games were imported successfully. We've got our notification over here, downloaded all of our artwork that we need. Last thing that's left to do here is just try to start a game up. Now, in the past, we had to manually configure the ScumVM emulator, but now Launchbox can do everything for us. So let's say we wanted to play Day of the Tentacle. It's going to come up with the ScumVM install wizard. Basically, this is going to allow us to download and configure ScumVM automatically. I'm going to choose yes. Launchbox is automatically going to download everything and configure it for us. So give this just a little bit of time. Once this is finished, we can start playing these ScumVM games. Now that it's finished, we'll just double-click on Day of the Tentacle. And there it is. We're now playing ScumVM in Launchbox. It's that easy to set this up now with the new version of Launchbox 13.15. Really awesome to see this. And again, in the past, there were a few things we needed to do to get this up and running. But now, basically, we can just import our games. It's going to download everything for us, and we can play these games. And since Launchbox automatically downloaded and configured the emulator for us, I did want to give you a look here. Tools, Manage, Emulators. We've got our ScumVM emulator set up, ready to go. We choose Edit. Everything's already set up for us. As you saw, you can start playing your favorite ScumVM games. Super easy to do. Really glad that this feature was added. The next new feature I wanted to talk about here was enhanced ROM importing, and this is really cool. For instance, emulators like RPCS3, I've got PS3 right here, when we set the emulator up, we actually import these games into the emulator itself. Same thing with something like Vita 3K. Now, with this new version of Launchbox, all we need to do to get our games imported with a system like this, RPCS3 or Vita 3K, is obviously already have the emulator set up, but then we just need to add said emulator to Launchbox and it'll automatically import the games for us. So I'm going to give you a rundown here with Vita 3K. Tools, Manage, Emulators. We're going to add a new emulator. From our emulator name dropdown, we're going to find Vita 3K. Now we need to locate where we have our Vita 3K folder. I've already set mine up in my Launchbox directory just to keep everything together, but this can be set up anywhere. It's under emulators. And down here, I've got Vita 3K. We're going to choose our application. Open. And since we use the emulator name dropdown, this is already set up, ready to go. We'll choose OK. We're going to close this down. Now we're going to restart Launchbox. And once Launchbox starts back up, it's automatically going to import those games for us and download all of our artwork. We'll see a little section up top here. So my 5 games were imported here. All of my artwork is downloaded. We'll head down here to our PS Vita section. And there we have it. So we've got our PlayStation Vita games imported right now. We can start one up. Launchbox automatically found that we had those games imported in Vita 3K and then imported them directly into Launchbox. Really nice little setup here. And again, this does work for RPCS3, so it's going to make it really easy to get everything imported correctly. So yeah, really loving this new enhanced ROM importing feature we've added with Launchbox 13.15. Now let's just say we remove some games from Vita 3K. So from Vita 3K, we're just going to remove Worms here. We're going to delete. We'll close this down. Start Launchbox back up. As you can see, it's still here until we scan for removed games. Tools. Scan. For removed ROMs on any platform. Or you could do it directly for Vita 3K here. And it's gone. It knows that that game was deleted from Vita 3K itself, and it's no longer in Launchbox. And the final new feature I wanted to talk about with this new release of Launchbox is our brand new plugin manager. So this is actually specific to emulators. We're going to go to Tools, Manage, Plugins. This supports official emulator plugins. As you can see, Dolphin, our GameCube and Wii emulator, provides functionality to allow Dolphin to be automatically installed and updated within Launchbox. Got a MAME, PCSX2, RetroArch, Scum, and right now in my setup, ScumVM. We've got a filter at the top. We're taking a look at all of them right now. Installed, updates available. All of my plugins are updated right now, and not installed. Can also sort by title, last updated, and popularity. Once updates are available through the plugin manager, we can go ahead and update very easily. So yeah, that's going to wrap it up for this Launchbox news video. We really hope you enjoyed 13.15. We've got a lot more coming down the road, so definitely keep an eye on the channel and the forum. But that's it for this one. And like always, thanks for watching.